Folks, several weeks ago, Microsoft released Office Mobile for Android phones, and we wanted to give you a webinar and show you what that's all about, okay? So I'm switching the camera down here to our phone, and I'm going to go to the home screen here. Let's talk about system requirements for this app. You need an Android phone, of course. This is a Samsung Galaxy Nexus phone. You need the operating system version to be 4.0 or later, and you need a touch keyboard. You can't have one of those Android phones with the hard keyboard with the actual keys. The other thing you need is an Office 365 subscription account, okay? And this could be Office 365 Home Premium, or it could be an Office 365 for Business account. But you do need that account. And if you're curious about which account you need, you can go up to our blog post, which is aka.ms/android123, and you can see there a list of the accounts that you'll need. Actually, it's a link. You click the link and you'll see information on which accounts provide this app. So I have it installed here on this phone, and I'm going to go ahead and launch it. Okay, and the first thing you see is the recent documents panel, and this shows you recent documents you may have edited on any device, your PC, your Mac, your Surface, maybe you have another phone, okay? They'll show up right here. So your recent documents always roam with you, okay? Some people say, why would you ever have Office on your phone? You don't need the Office on your phone. It's, you know, that's detailed work. Why would you put it on a small screen like your phone? Well, here's an example. I like to use addresses for postcards, put them in a Word document so that I can refer to them when I'm on a trip. Okay, I'm not as organized with my contacts. You may have addresses in your contacts on your phone. I didn't put all those in, okay? I just keep a small subset of them in this document. But we'll go back here. And because I've logged into this mobile app with my 365 Home Premium account, I can go here to the Open panel, and I've got my SkyDrive here. So I'll go ahead and go into SkyDrive. Okay, and I'll open up some folders here and browse to all my files. Of course, these are files not on your phone. They're not resident to the local phone. They are on your cloud, right? And when you want to open something, you just tap it. And at the moment, Office Mobile, of course, comes with Word, PowerPoint, and Excel, which is great. If you happen to have OneNote notebooks up there and you have the OneNote for Android app installed, you can tap a OneNote file and open it in that app. That works great. So I'm going to go ahead and also show you another way to open files, and that is through email. Because you often get files emailed to you, and you think, oh, I can't do anything with this because I'm not at my PC or I'm not at my Mac. But, you know, I can't do anything with this file. You can. You absolutely can. So go to your email app. That's what I'm going to do here. And Sean has sent me a message with this Word doc attached. There's nothing in the email message. You just sent me the file. This probably happens to you a lot when you say, hey, Sean, send me that file. Doesn't say anything but sends you an attachment. Okay. And here's our proposal document. And I'm going to go ahead and tap view. And then I always open in Office Mobile, okay? Because Office Mobile is the best way to read your Office documents, okay? Now this document is fully optimized for this phone. I'm not getting any crazy font substitution. I don't have any awkward layout problems for the most part. It's nice and formatted for the phone, okay? There are two main things you can do with these apps. You can either be in read mode, which lets you read and read comments, peruse, that kind of thing, or you can edit. Okay, so tap that document to get your tools, and I'll show you this, what I call the section jumper or the heading jumper tool here. You can jump here between different headings in the document. So for example, if I wanted to jump to custom research, I could do that. And if I wanted to jump to shared values, I could do that, okay? This is good because your eyes won't get tired as you're scrolling through dozens and dozens of pages. That's kind of hard on your eyes, so I recommend using this. Whenever you have a panel like this and you need to get rid of it, go ahead and tap that back button, and then you'll be able to get back to the document itself. The other thing you can do here is you can read comments. So here's a quote balloon that signifies a comment's been inserted. So I'll tap that guy and the comment panel will come up here and I can go ahead and read it and I can advance through if I need to the next comment. Okay, jump around as I need to. So that's reading comments. When I need to edit, I tap this pencil icon here. So I'll tap there and I'll be in edit mode and I can go ahead and position that cursor and type some text here. Okay. Whenever you need to save, you tap these three little dots. Normally three dots like that are horizontally oriented and it sort of signifies that there's more behind that button. So I'll go ahead and tap that. In this case, they're vertical, just the way it's designed. And go ahead and tap save, and you can save it to your SkyDrive. Some people think, oh, am I saving this locally to my phone right now? No, it's being saved to SkyDrive up in the cloud. And I guess technically it's probably saved first to the phone and then immediately uploaded, but the way I think of it always is it's saving to the cloud. So I'm gonna tap OK, it'll save it up there. Okay, uploads that file. Okay, let's show you the PowerPoint version of the app. So we'll go home, and again, we'll open email. I'm gonna open email just because I wanna get it ingrained in your heads that when you get an attachment, you're not bound to opening it in some, you know, other app that may be on your phone. You can open it in Office Mobile, okay? And this is PowerPoint here. It has a similar UI. You've got your tools at the top here, okay? Here's how PowerPoint works. You're in slideshow mode by default. And at the top, you've got your slide content. And then down here, you've got your notes pane, okay? And it's really best seen when you rotate it. So I'll go ahead and rotate this here and get it to flip to landscape. There we go. Orient it so it's a little, so it's straight for you. There you go. And then to advance forward through the slides, you just go ahead and swipe and your animations and transitions happen just like they would on the PC. Okay. So when you need to edit this file, it's just like the other one. You just tap that pencil icon. So I'll switch the phone around here. Just a quick note about the auto rotate there. You know how PowerPoint just repositioned itself so that it could display across the screen and in landscape mode. A lot of Android phones aren't set up to auto rotate like that by default. So you're going to want to go to settings and then display and turn on auto rotate. So here we go. If we wanted to edit, we could. We just tap that pencil icon, okay? And then we tap in the slide content. You can't do a lot of heavy editing. I mean, please tell me you don't want to edit a bunch of motion paths or do some video editing in here. It's meant for lightweight editing, right? It's a phone. So, don't expect to do some heavy changes, but you can make content changes, okay? And I'll go ahead and make a quick change here. There we go. Tap done, and then back to the slideshow. Okay, and if you need to make speaker notes changes, you can do that. Tap in the speaker notes and make those changes. It's really best if you need to practice a presentation and maybe you're standing in line for something or you're waiting for a plane or a bus or you're in a taxi and you just need time to practice your talking points. It works great for that. Let me show you Excel. It's my favorite because it lets me track things, right? So I'll go back here to SkyDrive. There's that proposal document we just saved earlier. It saved it to the very root of the drive. Go to Documents, Personal. I'm gonna show you this personal expenses spreadsheet that I use. Okay. This is probably the one that people are in most disbelief when it comes to using Office on the phone, because they think, oh, you know, spreadsheets are detailed, lots of cells, lots of data, tiny little data points all over the place. Well, I like to make little spreadsheets for the phone. So I made this personal expenses spreadsheet here, and it keeps me on track. I have a particularly hard time keeping my dining and entertainment expenses down to a reasonable level. So I made this tiny little spreadsheet for myself that helps me track, okay? In fact, let me show you a little bit more here. The tools, of course, are at the top, just like they were in the other apps, okay? The one that is probably the one to get used to the most is this tab icon here. Go ahead and tap that. And that's how you navigate through your sheets in the Excel file, okay? Versus, you know, when you're on Mac or PC, they're at the bottom. So they're at the top here, okay? Similar to that heading jumper that we used in Word. And you can go ahead and you can tap these different tab names and jump to those particular tabs. The way I have this set up is that, let's say I just finished eating, I need to record the total for the bill, right? Let's say I just spent, you know, $30 on dinner. I can go ahead and tap anywhere on that sheet, okay, and go back to totals, and it'll total up all of dining. All values on the dining sheet will get totaled. I'll show you that formula there. Here's the sum, and it's summing up the dining sheet, and pound A through IV, that means the whole sheet's getting totaled, no matter which cell has numbers in it, okay? That way I don't have to be super careful about where I'm entering a number. I can just say, oh, okay, I'll go to the dining tab, I just finished eating, and I'll tap anywhere on here and just enter, you know, a number for the total, okay? And I'll go back to totals, and that'll add that additional value there, sum it up. And then, of course, I added this little if column here. So there's a little equation here that says, or a formula that says, if the dining expenses, cell C2, exceeds 200, then display the text too much. And if I'm under that, then display the text on target. So I'll just show you that real quick. It's kind of a nifty deal. Go to dining. Let's say I just spent a bunch of money on my family for a holiday dinner or something. Okay. Go back to that totals tab. And you can see, okay, yep, I now know I've spent too much. I've spent more than my allotted dining expenses. Of course, you can also do totals here. So I'll, you know, sum these guys up. Okay. Lots of fun stuff in this Excel app. And just remember, if you ever need to save, the three dots and then save. I think that wraps it up today for Office Mobile for Android phones. Thanks very much for joining us. Really appreciate it. If you have any questions, join us for the Q&A immediately after. And we'll do any other demos that you might need. Join us next week because we're going to talk about Project and we're going to talk about baselines. It's our fourth webinar on Project, getting you ramped up using Project. And we hope you can join us for that. Thanks everyone today on the webinar team, and folks, stick around for the Q&A. Thanks.